In this video, we will set up a new project in WaferPro Express defining our measurements on our devices. We will give our new project a name, specifying project folder name and project location. WaferPro Express then creates a new directory. After specifying a lot name, we may define a test sequence at a given temperature and choose a wafer. Opening up the wafer map, we see that it does not reflect our loaded wafer. Fortunately, we may transfer the wafer map from Velox to WaferPro Express by clicking the button Get Wafer Map. This updates the wafer map to what we know to be correct based on our automatic alignment. So now WaferPro Express knows the dimension and location of the reticles within the wafer as well as the wafer dimension. Each reticle or die has been assigned a name based on its XY coordinates within the wafer map. Now we need to define where within each reticle we need to probe. So we look at subsites within the wafer. After clicking the Get Subsites button, we may retrieve subsite locations from the Velox software using the Get Subsite Table button. Here we see the two devices we defined, SG600 and IDCAP, one offset from the other by almost 400 microns. Next, we want to add these subsites to our measurement table. So we click on Add Measurement Device, select the whole die, and then Add a Subsite. Now we select the device SG600 and add it to our list of devices within the reticle. We specify this device to be a MESFET based on the pull-down list. After we click Add to Measure, our device gets added to the measurement table. The next device is just a capacitor, so we can select the device type DEV2PORT and add the IDCAP subsite to the list of devices, and then click again Add to Measure. Now both devices have been added to the measurement table. I need to pause for a second to explain the basic structure for measurement routines within WaferPro Express. Given a certain device type, we have created measurement routines to conduct all the most typical measurements for a given device type. Then, leveraging existing routines, we may specify specific bias ranges using what we call measurement groups. In our case, we want to measure S parameters at a controlled DC bias point, so we select DC_SP, and then our desired custom routine. After giving the measurement group name, we hit OK. We may now specify measurement parameters like start and stop frequency and bias conditions. The number of frequency points needs adjustment, so we will fix that to 201 to make it consistent with the RF calibration. Note that we need to specify DC bias for IV curves as well as for S parameter measurements. We will apply a fine-grained sweep for the DC-IV measurements, but only measure S parameters at a few bias points. Next, for the capacitor structure, we need to define another measurement group, this time without DC bias. We choose SP for S parameters only. Here again, we need to align the frequency start, stop, and number of points to our network analyzer stimulus settings during calibration. Next, we choose which reticle we want to probe, so I click on Edit Die List icon. We may add specific die to the test sequence by simply double-clicking which ones we want. At this point, we are ready to run the measurement, either manually on individual devices or as a test plan. Please see our video demonstrating this in action. You may check out other videos in this series for further useful demonstrations like how to configure WaferPro Express with instruments and prober control software, wafer alignment, or on-wafer RF calibration.